First tonight, the horror smash that's left a truck driver dead.
Incredibly, two other drivers survived the pile-up that's closed the Hume since last night.
And the costly clean-up is set to take some time yet. Ten's Yasmin Payton begins our coverage.
It's hard to believe anyone survived this.
She was extremely lucky, extremely.
But quick thinking from 22-year-old Monique Hillenaar meant she escaped almost certain death by the narrowest of margins.
It would have only been a matter of 20 seconds, maybe.
She was driving along the Hume Freeway near Violet Town around 11 o'clock last night when she skidded on spilled diesel and slammed into an overturned double B tanker.
And I just heard this horrific bang, and it sounded like a concertina type thing going off.
Smelling the fuel and seeing headlights approaching from behind, she made a dash for the median strip just moments before a second truck obliterated her vehicle. Monique escaped with just whiplash and is now recovering with her boyfriend and parents in Benalla.
She's in shock, naturally, but luckily she's got no injuries at this stage.
So too the driver of the second truck from Sydney, who'll undergo counselling before returning to the roads. 53-year-old Mel Deacon wasn't so lucky.
He was always willing to help out, really friendly, outgoing, and always would stop. Going past, he'd always stop and say hello.
The father of two died at the scene. Police yet to determine what caused his tanker to jackknife.
The investigations are only very early and it's going to take the crews quite some hours to try and figure out what's happened.
In Benalla, emotions are torn as one family ponders what might have been, another is grieving.
With so much fuel on board, the crash has created a dangerous challenge for emergency crews. Reporter Yasmin Payton joins us live now from Violet Town. And Yas, any word on when the highway will reopen?
Well, Helen, I just spoke to one of the police officers here and he said that the southbound lane should be reopened any minute, and that means that traffic travelling through to Melbourne will soon be able to get through. He also said the northbound lane headed towards Violet Town should be reopened by 10 o'clock tonight. But as you can see behind me, the trucks and the car still need to be cleared and huge cranes have been brought in to do that job. Authorities will then wash the road before checking that it is safe for traffic. The spilled fuel has not only caused complications with the cleanup, it's also had an impact on the local environment. TEN's Alicia Morrison filed this report.
A 70-kilometre stretch of the freeway was shut down from midnight as traffic was diverted from as far as Seymour. With 40 of the 66,000 litres of fuel spilled, emergency crews weren't taking any chances.
We've actually got foam over the top of it, which is trying to maintain a barrier over it so that the vapours aren't free.
Residents nearby could smell petrol and were ordered to switch off power.
Had no lights on or any power. We just switched all the power off last night, except the electric fences were going.
Fire crews say any bare flames could have triggered further disaster and were amazed the impact of three high-speed crashes hadn't already ignited the load of fuel.
If there had been any flame at all or any ignition of the fuel here last night, none of these trucks would still be standing here now.
More than 50 firefighters worked to contain the spill. The leaked mixture of petrol and diesel travelled almost 100 kilometres along a nearby creek, with sand and hay bales used to block its path. Violet Town residents were also advised to stay indoors.
Especially the elderly, stay indoors and keep the windows locked and turn off any gas appliances.
The remaining fuel has been transferred to another tanker, but a lot soaked into the ground.
The stuff that's on the creek is going to be the easiest, whereas within the ground they're going to have to actually dig it out.
Environment protection staff are supervising the clean-up and will continue to monitor the area. Alicia Morrison, 10 News.